Hello and welcome to the spoken tutorial on creating and meshing a curved pipe geometry in Salome for OpenFOAM. In this tutorial, we will see to create curved pipe geometry in Salome, to mesh the geometry in Salome, and to modify the mesh using submesh. To record this tutorial, I am using Linux operating system Ubuntu version 12.10 and Salome version 6.6.0. To practice this tutorial, the learner should have Salome installed on his computer. If not, then you may refer to the tutorial on downloading and installing Salome. Open Salome software by clicking on Salome icon on the desktop. Click on Geometry Modules in the Modules bar and click on New. Let's click on New Entity in the top menu bar. In the drop-down options, go to Basic and then 2D Sketch. First point is 0, 0 by default. Press Apply. In front of Y, type 30 and click on Apply. Now go to second element type, Arcs. Select type as direction and direction as tangent. Type the radius as minus 10 and the angle as 90. Press apply. Now select the element type as lines. Select the type as direction and direction as tangent. Type the length as 30. Press apply and close. Let me zoom in for the closer view. Open the geometry tree in the object browser. We can see sketch 1. You can check off to hide the sketch and check on to see it back. Now go to new entity, blocks, divided disk. Select the orientation as OZX and type the radius equal to 1. Click on apply and close. Now go to new entity, generation, extrusion along path. Select the base object as divided disk and path object as sketch 1 from the geometry tree. Click on apply and close. We see pipe 1 has been created. Now go to new entity, explode. Select the main object as pipe 1. In the subshapes type drop down menu, select face. Check on select subshapes. Let me move this window. Let me zoom in by scrolling up. I can rotate the object by clicking on this rotation menu. Hold the left mouse button and move the mouse upwards to rotate the object. Take the mouse pointer at the place shown on the screen. Hold the left mouse button, drag the mouse so that all the inlet faces fall into the rectangular area. Release the mouse. Now click on Show Only Selected button to ensure that all the inlet faces have been selected. Click on Apply and Close. We see 5 faces have been exploded in the geometry tree. Now click on New Entity, Group, Create. Select the main shape as Pipe 1 from the geometry tree. Select the shape type as Face. Now select the 5 faces from the geometry tree. Add them by clicking on this Add button. Name the group as Inlet. Click on Apply and Close. We see inlet group has been created. Follow the similar procedure on the other end of the pipe and group those faces as outlet. I have created outlet face group. Now to mesh the object, go to Modules drop down menu. Select Mesh. Now in the top menu bar, click on Mesh. create mesh. Select the geometry as pipe 1. From the geometry tree, click on assign a set of hypotheses button. Click on 3D automatic hexahedralization. Type the number of segments 12. Click on OK. Click on apply and close. We see mesh 1 in the geometry tree. Right click on it. Click on compute. Close the window. We see mesh has been created. Let me zoom in. I can move the object by this panning option. Now we will refine the mesh in the flow direction. To do so, go back to geometry module from modules drop down menu. Now let me get the proper view by using panning and rotation option. Let me zoom out. Go to new entity, explode, select the main object as pipe 1, subshapes type, edge, check on select subshapes. Let me move the window to the corner. Now take the mouse pointer as shown on the screen, hold the left mouse button, drag the mouse so that all the outlet face edges fall inside the window. Release the left mouse button. The selected edges are seen in white color. Click on hide selected. Similarly, there are three more face edges that we need to select one by one and hide. After that, you would only see the edges in the flow direction. Let me zoom out. Move the object. Select all of these edges using similar method. And click on apply and close. In the geometry tree below outlet, we see 24 edges have been exploded. To group these edges, go to new entity, group, create, select the shape type as edge, select the main shape as pipe 1 from the geometry tree. Now select all of these edges and click on add button to add these edges. Name the group as flow edges. Click on apply and close. We see flow edges group has been created. Now go to mesh module from modules drop down option. Right click on mesh 1. Click on create submesh. Select the geometry as flow edges. Select the algorithm wire discretization. Now to select the appropriate hypothesis, click on first button to the right of drop down menu. Click on NB segments. Type the number of segments as 30. Click on OK. Click on apply and close. Now click on mesh 1. Click on compute. Refined mesh has been created. Close the window. We see mesh has been refined in the flow direction. To save this work, go to file, save as, type the file name as curved geometry. I am saving this work on desktop. Save. Minimize Salome. We see file has been saved as curvedgeometry.hdf. In this tutorial, we have learned to create curved pipe geometry in Salome, to mesh the geometry in Salome, and to modify the mesh using submesh. For assignment, create a pipe having inner diameter 6 units smaller than the outer diameter. Change the angle of the vent. The video is available at the following URL. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT-MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at spoken-tutorial.org/nmeict-intro. I am Saurabh Saman from IIT Bombay. Thank you.